Hello, everyone. Hopefully I'm doing this right. This is my first time live streaming from the Soulshine page. If you can see me and hear me, someone throw up a comment. All right. Good morning. Hey, Ash. Hi, guys. All right, we're going to get started then. All right, good to go. If everyone wants to get down on their mats, on your back, we're just going to try to relax a little bit, settle in. I'll get a little music playing. It's not very loud. To just settle in and relax. Try to release any tension that we've been carrying around. I'm sure we all have been carrying it in light of our current situation. So releasing your feet to the corners of your mat, your hands alongside you. That you feel yourself carrying, letting your feet just fall out to the corners of your mat, coming up from your feet through your legs, feeling if your arms are really released or if maybe you're holding on still. Try to relax your jaw, bringing your lips to a light seal. Release that tension between your eyebrows. Begin to look at your breath. Is it shallow or choppy? With your lips lightly sealed, begin to focus on your nose-to-nose breathing, inhaling through your nose, exhaling through your nose, maybe lengthening your breath to a count of three or four, and exhaling that same count. I think practicing yoga right now and really focusing on our home practice is beneficial to our mental health and our physical bodies during this time. I know I've been spending a lot of time eating and drinking and probably not practicing enough, so I'm happy to be here with you this morning. Moments of that breath, remembering this breath as we move through our asanas, through our flows. Remembering that this is your practice and I will guide you, but please modify as needed, take breaks. Do what suits you for the next 45 minutes. Start to bring some awareness back to your body, wiggling those fingers and toes, rolling your wrists and ankles, maybe rocking your head from side to side. On your next exhale, draw your knees into your chest, giving yourself a hug. Maybe a little rock or lower back massage. When right knee into your chest. Extend your left leg overhead and just press that heel towards the ceiling, feeling that stretch down the back of your leg. Maybe finding some circles. Releasing your right knee, reach up, grabbing your left leg, feeling that little bit deeper stretch. So you lower back down, bring your arms to a T, dropping your right knee to the floor beside you, your left leg still extended, finding that side twist. Maybe bringing your gaze over your left shoulder. Inhaling back to center, we'll draw our knees in. This time we'll hug our left knee to our chest and extend your right foot overhead, pressing in. Reaching up, feeling that deeper stretch. Finally, dropping your left knee to the floor, bringing your arms to that T. Inhale back to center, one last hug before we find that gentle forward to back rock, finding a seat. Crossing our legs in that easy pose. We'll inhale, arms up. Exhaling, hands down to heart center. Closing your eyes gently and taking a moment here to set an intention for your practice. Maybe that's just to breathe. We'll inhale back overhead, dropping our right hand down beside you, left hand extended overhead, reaching to the right. Maybe bringing your gaze up to your left palm. Inhaling back to center, exhaling other side. As we inhale to center, we're gonna bring our left hand to our right knee. Right hand comes behind you, finding a twist. Inhaling to center, we'll go to the other side. Right hand on left knee. As we inhale, we'll find that forward fold. Maybe inching your hands a little bit farther, stretching those shoulders. We'll inhale to rise. Planting our hands, we're going to find that neutral tabletop, so that may mean rocking forward and coming up, or maybe you're going to swing your legs out to the side. Coming to this table with our hands underneath our shoulders, our knees under our hips, feeling that neutral spine, we'll begin to go through some cats and cow movement, warming up our spine. So on our inhale, we'll lift our gaze, drop our belly, lift our tail, finding our cow pose. Exhaling to tuck our tail, drop our gaze. Cat pose. So with your inhales and exhales, find that movement for a few breaths. You can take some hip circles here. Or maybe finding those belly rolls. Meet back in that neutral spine. We're going to do a little balance here, extending our left arm in front of us, palm facing to the side, press your right foot behind you, feeling that straight line from the tip of your fingers down to the bottom of your feet, heel should be pressed to the back of your mat. We'll exhale to crunch, inhale out, two more times, exhale to crunch, inhale up, one more time. Hinge your knee, pressing your heel back up to the ceiling, and let's just reach for that foot. Maybe your ankle, maybe you're not gonna make contact, but go through the movement and just press. Release that hand back to the mat and your knee back down. Maybe finding a quick cat and cow. As we do the other side, pressing our right hand in front of us, that palm facing sideways, left foot behind you. Exhaling to crunch, inhaling up, exhale to crunch. Inhale up. Last time. Come back to that straight line. Kick your foot up. Right hand comes behind you. Grabbing for that foot. We'll release that bind, bringing our hand and our knee back to the mat. We're going to find our first downward dog, probably of the day, maybe not. Tucking our toes, pressing up. Belly should be pressed towards your thighs. Fingers straight in front of you, heels and toes facing forward. Breathing into this space, feeling for any tightness. Bring your gaze between your hands as we go through some sun salutation A's, walking to the front of your mat, finding that halfway lift, bring your hands to your shins, straight spine. Exhale down, forward fold. Walk your hands to the right, side of your mat, twisting, feeling the stretch in your legs. Come back to center, other side. Back to center. As we inhale, we're going to rise up, extending our arms overhead. Exhaling, hands to heart center. I'm grazing my ceiling here. Inhale, back up. Right hand grabs left wrist, pulling to the right. As we come back to center, we'll grab the other wrist, pulling to the left. Come back to center, release that bind. Swing your right hand behind you, we're gonna find a T-twist here. Gaze down towards your right hand, left arm extended in front of you. As we inhale, we'll drop our right hand down to the back of our right leg. Left arm extends up, reverse. Right arm comes up, T-twist to the left. Find that reverse, left hand down the back of your left leg, gaze up to your right palm. Inhale, drawing the left hand up. We'll swan dive out, finding that forward fold. Halfway lift. Plant your hands, step your feet back, finding a high plank. Neutral spine here. Try not to keep your tail up. We'll hold here for a few breaths. On our exhale, we're going to lower through our chaturanga, hugging our elbows towards our ribs. When you're about an inch or two to your mat, we're going to press up, finding our up dog or cobra. Tuck our toes, downward facing dog. Step or hop to the front of your mat. Find a halfway lift, fold it in. Plant your left hand, right arm lifts, slight bend in your left knee. Release our hand back to the mat, opposite side, slight bend in right knee. We'll find the mat and we'll inhale up. We're gonna find a chair pose here, bringing our toes together. Inch or two between your heels. Pressing our legs and sinking in. Gazing down, you should be able to see your toes between your knees. Checking your shoulders, make sure they're not pulled up. Drop them down into the socket. We're going to find a bind with our hands. Swing your arms down to the right. Your elbow should be right around the outside of your right knee, a little bit higher. We're going to press our hands into our chest, finding that prayer hand twist. Fingers should be pressed towards your sternum, your heart. On our inhale, we'll lift our arms, keep those chair legs. Pressing your legs together, opposite side. Draw your hands in. You guys are doing great, I know this burns. Release and rise all the way up. As we release our bind, we'll swan dive out. Finding a halfway lift, press back, put your hands and step back, I mean. There's always an option here to come down to your knees or just go straight to your downward facing dog. So we're lowering through our chaturanga, pressing up, up dog or cobra. Tucking our toes, finding our downward facing dog. Breathing here. We'll step or hop to the front of your mat. Last sun salutation. Halfway lift. Fold it in. When inhale to rise. Having a little fun here. Grounding into that left foot. Drawing your right knee up. Pulling it in. Drawing it into your chest. You can stay like this, or if you want, we can go into a quick gentleman squat on the right. Crossing your leg, finding that figure four, a little bit above your knee. Drawing our hands into heart center, sinking in. I'm a little wobbly. We'll inhale back up, release that foot, maybe do a little walk out. Draw your left knee into your chest. Crossing into that gentleman squat here, ankle a little bit above your knee. Sinking down, breathing. Inhale back up, releasing that, swan diving out. Halfway lift, plant your hands, step back. We're gonna go into a child's pose here. You can go through your half vinyasa if you want, or just right to child's pose. Pushing back, bringing your toes together, spreading your legs a little bit, fit your torso in between your legs, reaching in front of you. Breathing here. If this is not comfortable for you, you can bring your legs together, arms behind you. Or maybe just find this resting pose here. So just breathe here. We're gonna start our first flow in a moment. We got a little bit shorter class. So I'm gonna take us through two flows. Like I said, you can always modify. Do what suits you. And remember, there's always that option to skip the vinyasa. Go right to downward facing dog. From your child's pose, resting pose, we're going to come into a downward facing dog. Pressing up, tucking our toes. Feeling how this feels different than the first one we did. Right leg lifts, a three-legged dog. We're going to bend our leg and just do some heel presses towards the ceiling, about three. Come back to three-legged dog. We're gonna stretch our right leg up, planting our foot between our hands, finding a warrior two, opening up here, bringing your back foot to a 90-degree angle. Knee should be tracking over ankle. Gaze down your fingers. Straighten your front leg. We'll hinge forward slightly, tipping in, finding a triangle here, keeping your tail tucked in, hand on the inside of your right leg. Inhale back up to warrior two. We'll find a reverse, that peaceful warrior. Left hand down your back of your left leg or maybe along your lower back. Keeping a bend in your front knee. Gaze at your palm. As we inhale, we'll come back to warrior two. Finding our side angle pose. Forearm along your thigh. Left hand overhead. Try not to put too much weight in your right arm. As we inhale, we're gonna rise up, pointing our toes to the corners of our mat. Exhaling in, hands to heart center. We're gonna find that skandhasana, that side lunge to the back of your mat. It may be like this. You may come all the way down. We'll inhale to skandhasana at the front of your mat, or the side lunge, as deep as you want. Using your hands to walk if you want. When inhale, back to that five-pointed star. Sinking in, finding our goddess squat. Holding here for a moment. Bring your hands down to your thighs as we dip our shoulders in. We'll just do three times each side. After your sixth time, total. Rise back up, finding our five-pointed star. Bring your right foot pointing back towards the front of the room. Sink into your warrior two. As we pivot onto the ball of our back foot, we're gonna plant our hands. Step your right foot back. We're in that high plank. Lowering through our chaturanga to up dog or cobra. Downward facing dog. Left leg lifts. Finding that little kick. Heel presses towards the ceiling. Knee back and three-legged dog. Step your left leg through as we rise up. Warrior two on the left. Back foot should be parallel to the short edge of your mat. We'll straighten our front leg. Tip forward. Triangle pose. Inhale to warrior two. Reverse. Come back to warrior two. We'll inhale up, pivoting those feet a little bit, finding that hand to heart center, side lunge. Inhale, side lunge to the top of your mat. Sink in, cactus arms, finding that goddess squat. Bring your hands to your thighs as we find the shoulder dips on this side. We'll inhale to rise. Pivot that left foot to the front of your mat. Warrior two. Bring our hands to the mat as you come to the ball of your back foot. Step back. Vinyasa. Do this two more times on each side. Right leg comes up as we do those heel presses. Three-legged dog to step through. Inhale, warrior two. Straighten your front leg. Inch forward slightly. Tip in, triangle. Inhale to warrior two. Reverse. Come up, find your side angle. Inhale to five-pointed as we draw our hands to heart center. Skandasana, back of your mat. If you'd like, maybe using your hands to find that Skandasana at the top of your mat. As we inhale, we'll rise up, five-pointed star. Sinking into our goddess squat. Maybe this time we'll place our hands behind our head and find these side crunches. Inhale to rise. Right foot points to the front of your mat. Sink into your warrior two as a transition to find that pivot and plant. Step back, vinyasa. Lift your left leg, heel presses. Come back to your three-legged dog as you step through. Warrior two on your left. Straighten your front leg, hinge forward, tip it in, triangle. Inhale to warrior two, reverse. Try not to straighten that front leg. Side angle, maybe an extended side angle here. Bringing your hand down closer to the mat. We'll inhale back up, finding that five-pointed star as we draw our hands into heart center. Skandasana. Front of the mat, Skandasana. We'll inhale to rise, five-pointed. Sink in, gotta squat. Do those side crunches on this side. We'll rise and release. Pivot your front foot, top of your mat. Sink into your warrior two. As we bring our hands to the mat, coming to the ball of our back foot, step through. Vinyasa are always an option. Coming straight to your downward facing dog. Breathing here for a moment. Last time, through on this low.
Right leg lifts.
Heel press. Come back to three-legged dog as you step through warrior two. Rise up. Straighten your front leg. Hinge forward, tip it in. Triangle. Maybe for a challenge here, reach forward. Act like you're grabbing a beach ball. As we inhale, back into warrior two. We'll reverse. Find your side angle. We inhale up to five pointed. Exhaling, hands to heart center. Skandasana. Maybe playing here with a little bit of a bind. Bringing your left hand around the front of your left shin. Right arm comes up. Behind, reaching for that left hand. We'll release as we find a Skandasana on top of our mat. If you'd like to try bind here, coming around the front, coming behind and meeting. Release and rise, five-pointed star. Sink into your goddess squat. Find any movement here that suits you. And then find a little bit of a different move before we bring this back down to the mat. We'll rise up, five-pointed. Bring your hands to your hips. As we hinge forward, we'll tip in, finding a wide leg forward fold. Grab your left, use your left hand to grab your right ankle. Reach your right arm overhead. Exhale to release and do the opposite side. As we release, we're gonna slowly roll up. Being careful and lifting your head last. We'll come up to five pointed. Bring that foot front of the mat, sink in. Warrior two is a transition. As we come back down, pivot and plant your hands, step back. Go through your half vinyasa, right to downward facing dog. Left leg lifts, heel press. Come back to three-legged dog, step it through. Warrior two. Straighten your front leg. Hinge forward. Triangle. Inhale to warrior two. Reverse. Come to side angle. Inhale, five-pointed. Hands down to heart center. Skandasana. Find that bind if you'd like. Maybe you just want to plant your hands and stretch. Inhale to the top of your mat. Inhale to rise, five-pointed. Sinking in, goddess. Inhale to rise, hands to your hips, hinge forward. Wide leg forward fold. We'll slowly rise up. Hands back to five-pointed. Pivot your foot to the front of your mat, sink in, warrior two. Hands come to the mat, step back, go through your vinyasa, if you'd like. Come into a child's pose. Take a few breaths here. All right, how you guys doing? Good. From your child's pose, we're going to meet in that downward facing dog. Lift your right leg. Draw your right knee into your right elbow. Come back up to three-legged dog. Right knee into left elbow. Back up. Right foot steps through. We're going to find that high lunge, that crescent. Hinge forward slightly, lightning bolt arms. We'll inhale back up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Planting our left foot behind your right, finding that curtsy squat. You can have your leg float here. We're going to draw our hands into heart as we do a few pulses. Rise back up, plant your hands. Standing split, left leg floats back, crescent. As we inhale up, we're going to find that bind like we did with our chair pose. Bring our hands down to the right side of our leg, drawing them in, finding that prayer hand twist. Release and then bring your hands back up to center. Hands plant, left hand stays on the mat, right hand lifts, dragonfly twist. Right hand comes back to the mat, right foot steps back, vinyasa. Left leg lifts, left knee, left elbow, back up, left knee, right elbow, back up, step it through, crescent, hinge forward, rise, hinge forward, inhale to rise. This time when we hinge forward, planting our hands, weight in your left foot, standing split. Cross your right foot behind your left. Curtsy squat. Plant our hands, step back up, standing split. Right foot floats back. Come back into our crescent. Find that bind. Exhale, hands down. Outside of your left leg. Draw your hands into your chest, finding that prayer hand twist on the left. Release and rise. And let go of your hands. We're planting our right hand, left arm lifts. Dragonfly twist. Left hand comes to the mat, step back. Finding your vinyasa. Breathing here for a moment. Right leg lifts. Right knee, right elbow. Back up. Right knee, left elbow. Back up. Stepping our right foot between our hands, we'll rise up, crescent. Exhale, hinge forward. Rise. Time as a hinge forward, putting our hands to the mat, standing split. Cross your right foot behind your left, curtsy squat, finding those pulses. Bring our hands back to the mat, standing split. Float your left foot back, rise up, back into our crescent. Find that bind. Bring our hands to the outside of our right knee. Hands to heart center. Release and rise. Left hand plant. Right hand lifts. Dragonfly twist. Right hand meets the left. Step back. Vinyasa or straight to downward dog. Left leg lifts. Left knee, left elbow. Back up. Left knee, right elbow. Back up. Left foot steps through, crescent. Exhale forward. We'll exhale forward this time, planting our hands, standing split. Curtsy squat, pulse. Planting our hands, standing split. Float your foot back. Crescent. That bind brings our hands to the outside of our left leg. Hands to heart. Coming back up. Right hand plants. Left hand lifts. Dragonfly twist. Left hand to the mat. Step back. Vinyasa, downward facing dog. Last time through and then we'll cool down. Lifting our right leg, right knee, right elbow, back up, Right knee, left elbow.
Back up.
Step through, crescent. Hinging forward. Inhaling to rise. Plant your hands, standing split. Find your curtsy, maybe float your foot here if you can. Hands plant, rise. Left foot floats back. Crescent. Finding that bind. Swinging our hands to the outside of our right knee. Pressing into your heart. We inhale to rise. Left hand plants. Right arm lifts. Dragonfly twist. Right hand plants. Step back. Going through our vinyasa. One more after this. Lift your left leg. Draw your left knee to your left elbow. Inhale back up. Left knee, right elbow.
Back up.
Left foot steps through. Crescent. Last time. We'll hinge forward on our exhale. Hands come to the mat, standing split. Curtsy squat. Maybe float that leg. Plant our hands. Standing split. Right foot floats back. Rising back into our crescent. Grabbing the hands together. Coming around. Outside of our left leg. Hands to heart. Release. Rise. Right hand plants. Left arm lifts. Dragonfly twist. Left hand comes to the mat. Step back. Meet in child's pose. The hard part's done. Now we're just going to cool down. Do some stretching. Take a few breaths here. We'll press up into a downward facing dog. Find our pigeon pose. Lift your right leg. As we draw our right knee towards our right wrist, we're gonna kick our leg out. So our ankle should be behind our left wrist. Finding our pigeon pose. The closer you draw your leg towards your body, the less stretch here. We'll inhale for length. Exhale to fold in. Inhale as we rise. Plant your hands. Tuck your toes. Press up. Draw your leg through. Find some hip circles. Bring your right foot to the mat. Left leg lifts. Finding our pigeon on our left. Left knee towards left wrist. Kick our leg through. Sink in. We'll inhale for length. Exhale, folding. Inhale, come back up. Tuck your right toes. Draw your left leg through, back to three-legged dog. Find those hip circles. Dropping our left foot, we're gonna come to our knees. Swinging our legs around, finding a seat. Send your legs in front of you. Finding a staff pose. We'll inhale, arms up. As we exhale, we'll hinge forward. Feeling that stretch. Releasing in. We'll inhale it up. Doing a few boats here. Practicing that core work. Drawing knees up. Trying to stay on your seat, not rolling back on your tail. We're extending our arms in front of us. Your boat may be on your tiptoes here. You could lift. Holding and drawing in on your core. Bring our hands up, down to heart, as we row our boat side to side. Release, back to the mat. Maybe finding a quick butterfly here, or windshield wiper in your legs. I don't think that's a word. We're gonna come back to boat. Arms extended in front of us. Find a slight butterfly like this. Bring your hands in front of you. As we inhale, our arms are gonna go overhead and our legs are gonna extend in front of us. Back in. Exhaling out. Inhaling one more time. Release. One more time if you want to try that full boat. Hands out in front of us, legs up. Maybe grabbing your legs, helping yourself out a little bit. Breathing two more. Release. Extend your legs in front of you as you lower to your back. Drawing your knees into your chest. Giving yourself a hug. Saying thank you. For giving yourself the time to work on you right now. Bring our arms to a T as you drop your legs to the left side of the room. Gaze over your right shoulder. Try to keep your right shoulder on your mat. We'll inhale back to center. Exhaling the opposite side. Inhale to center for that hug. We'll do some bridge poses here. We have a few minutes left. Feet should be a few inches from your seat. Hands alongside you. Press your hips up. Pressing your legs together. Two more breaths. Release. When you're ready, you can press back up. Maybe shimmy little shoulders underneath you. Finding a bind, your lower back. Release. This time is kind of up to you what you want to do. If wheels in your practice, you can go ahead and do that. Bring your hands behind your head, facing towards the back of your mat, next to your ears, and you can press up. Or if you'd like, we'll press into our bridge. Shimming those shoulders and maybe challenge yourself to come up on your tiptoes and kick a leg up at a time. Release back down. Windshield wipering. Once again, I'm not sure if that's a word. Drawing our knees in. Then extending them overhead into our candlestick pose. Heels pressed towards the ceiling, bottoms into your feet, towards the ceiling. If you'd like, you can find your shoulder stand here. Your plow pose. Bring our hands to our lower back. Pressing up, shoulder stand. Elbows should be closer together. Try not to splay them out. We're trying to get that straight line from our feet down to our
chin, chest. Plow to the back if you'd like. I'm not going to. When we're ready, we'll slowly roll down back into our candlestick. As your legs extend in front of you, we'll find a fish pose here. Forearms to the mat. Releasing your head towards the back of the mat. Slowly lower down. Having a few moments here to take that final movement that suits you. Maybe that's a happy baby. Grabbing the outside edges of your feet, rocking. Maybe making those check marks. A few more breaths here for that movement. Legs up to the corners of your mat, hands beside you for our final rest, our Shavasana. This is my cat, Gabe. Come back to your normal breath. And releasing into the mat. As we release the practice of our Shavasana, begin to wake those fingers and toes, finding movement in your wrists and ankles, maybe rocking your head from side to side. Extend your arms overhead as you bring your legs together. Deeply inhaling through your nose and releasing through your mouth, letting that last little bit go. Draw your knees into your chest for one last hug. Rocking forward, finding our easy pose one last time. We'll inhale back up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Closing your eyes and bowing your chin in gratitude for this body and this breath and this practice, this community. Gently lift your chin, keeping those eyes relaxed and closed. Know that I honor and bow to that place of light, love, and peace within each of you that is the same in me. Thank you so much for joining me for this practice. Namaste. Thanks, everybody. I'm so happy to join you again. I miss my Saturday classes. And I will see you next week.
Bye.